Hi, welcome back to CADable. This is Engr Ibrahim Omer, and in this short tutorial we will learn how to use Solidworks miter flange feature. So let's do this by an example. Let's go to your Solidworks, select part and select OK. And now we are in Solidworks interface. So first of all, I will change its background to plain white and I will set my units to mmjs. Okay, so let's go to your top plane, select a sketch, and here we will draw a center rectangle. Let's dimension this rectangle. Let's say this one is 150 and let's say this dimension is 75. Okay, let's go to your sheet metal and select this one, base flange tab, and here I will draw a tab of thickness, let's say 3, and I will select OK. Now we will draw a sketch for miter flange. So let's go to your sketch, select this face, and here we will draw a simple sketch for miter flange. So let's draw one line, let's say here, and then one line here, then one line here, then one line here. Okay, select all these lines and make them equal. Let's go to a smart dimension and let's say this dimension is 7, and now you can see that this sketch is fully defined. Okay, now we can use miter flange feature. So I will select miter flange and I will select this sketch. Okay, and I will change this radius to, let's say, 0.7, and now you can see the preview. I will select this edge, I will select this edge, and also I will select this edge. Now we will apply some gap here. Let's say this gap is 1 mm. Here you can see this gap, and let's say I can change this flange position. Okay, let's say I will use this one. Okay, and here I can use this as well. Okay, offset, let's change it to 0. Okay, you can play with these parameters. You can use this option as well, trim side bends. I will select OK. You can calculate its blank size. Select this one, flatten, and it is the blank size of this box. You can export this file for machining. Just right click and select this one, export DXF, and select save, and select this one, sheet metal, and I will add this one, bend lines, and I will select OK. Now it will give me a preview. Now you can see the preview. You can remove some entities, and remember one thing, that these lines, these center lines, are not part of your final sketch. So this outer periphery is the only sketch. I will select save, and now I can use this DXF file for machining and for making this box. So that's it for this tutorial. I hope you like this short tutorial, and if you have still some questions, some queries, you can ask in comment section. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to our channel for more informative and interesting projects. Thank you.